Welcome to Hybiz TV. My name is Suresh Kochatal. News that Anand Mahindra will give up his executive role at Mahindra & Mahindra from April 2020 has surprised many in the corporate circles. Managing Director Pawan Goenka will take over as a part of the succession plan at the auto and tractor maker. But what is interesting is that we are increasingly seeing elders in many family-run concerns giving up control, but mostly to their own family members. One of the few exceptions is what Mr. Anand Mahindra has done. Take many Indian business families, and the baton of succession is handed down to the next generation, just like monarchy.
Rahul Bajaj makes way for Rajeev Bajaj.
And then he complains in the wide audience that there's no democracy in this country. The same thing happened with Tatas, when Tatas actually over the generations kept on control with them, but finally it ended with Ratan Tata giving away to Cyrus Mistry, which of course resulted in a messy boardroom battle afterwards and saw his exit and the entry of Natarajan Chandrasekharan, who occupied the corner room at Bombay House. The Ambanis all too followed suit, but one brother went up like a rocket while the other crashed without a chance of a bailout. Just like politicians, businessmen and women are reluctant to retire and let others take charge. Professional conglomerates like L&T have created a smooth succession plan where the old guard identified the successors, groomed them and made way. The problem is more acute when senior level executive decides to quit, leaving a sudden vacuum in the organization. We saw that when Binny Bansal quit from Flipkart and Vinod Dasri quit as the managing director of Ashok Leyland. In fact, at Mahindra & Mahindra, Goenka will step into the newly created position of CEO from April for a year before handing over that charge to Mr. Shah, who will come into his position. Goenka, who has reached a superannuation age of 65 at M&M, has been given a year's extension by the board to mentor his successor. And that's an interesting thought. He will retire on 1st April 2021 after spending 4 years and 5 months at the helm. Kavil Ramchandran, a professor at Indian School of Business, says that Mahindra & Mahindra Group have been known to do such leadership grooming for years. According to Anand Mahindra, the selection process took account for both the internal and external candidates, and that's what resulted in the final decision. Human resource consultants say choosing someone sends a strong message to the organization that talent is often recognized within and given the right responsibility. Go Air, for example, saw two quick top-level exits, while Chanda Kochar quit as the head of ICICI under a cloud with 6 months to go before a term was to end. But how many organizations will actually do this? Succession planning is a strategy, and that has to be done very, very careful. Sudden level exits from the top management often shake the organization. And unless you have your succession planning in mind and create one, it'll leave a gaping hole. And that is a food for thought. Thank you.